Hi everyone, hope you are all fine. This is Atik. I once again welcome all of you to my channel Engineering Drive, and I once again welcome you to the continuation of my playlist of computer organization. And today I am going to go in some more depth now. So which means you can see the videos which I have uploaded till now. You may think that they may not be in so much of depth. Okay, the reason behind that is we need to understand basics first. Once our foundation is strong, then what happened? We can construct how many floats we want. It depends on our talent. Okay. The purpose of my channel is, the tagline of my channel is, whatever I will be teaching you, those things will be in simple way. Simple way means you can able to understand it very easily. Once you can understand the basics properly, then no matter easily you can able to go through to the next stages of your educational life. Okay. So, like this, today I am going to discuss one important concept of our computer organization, which means how our processor and memory, they will communicate with each other, what type of connection is available between them. So here, when I am talking about memory, it doesn't mean the hard disk here. It means that whenever I am talking about processor and memory communication, you should always think that we are talking about main memory, that is RAM. Connections between processor and RAM, how our processor and main memory will communicate with each other. So with the help of this very nice diagram, I am going to explain you the communication that will take place between CPU and main memory. So memory here refers to main memory. So you can see here, in my previous set of videos you might have watched, simply I told that initially the data will be available in hard disk, from hard disk it is brought into RAM, from RAM it is brought into cache memory, and from cache memory to CPU. Now here we have not included the cache memory and hard disk. Our main purpose is how the communication will take place from main memory to processor, that I am going to show here. Oh, okay. So let us say this is our entire processor. Generally in our processor, we know that there, in our CPU, there are three important parts. One is arithmetic and logic unit, control unit, second part, and what we call this remaining entire part, they are known as registers. What we call them? Registers. A CPU contains three parts. One is arithmetic and logic unit, second one control unit, and the third one is, we call them as registers. What are registers? Registers are a very small place to store a very small amount of data. They are not very large in size. They can hold only limited amount of information. So where those registers are available? Inside our CPU itself, inside our processor itself. Okay. Now, what are the uses of all those registers, and how our processor will make use of these registers in order to access the data from memory, or in order to give the data to memory? That I am going to discuss here. Okay. Let us say initially the data will be in somewhere in hard disk. The data will be brought into main memory. And now what our CPU will do? From main memory, the data will be brought to CPU. I told in many times in my previous videos that simply I told that data will be brought into CPU. Where the data will be stored now? I told you, our CPU will execute the data in the form of instructions. This is very, very important point. It won't execute entire program at a time. CPU will execute instruction wise, which means when our processor will fetch the first instruction from memory, what happened? Before that, our processor will specify the address. This is the first step, step number one. What is MAR? This is a register which is available in every processor. MAR stands for memory address register. What is MAR? Memory address register. Processor will give the first, it will specify where the instruction is available in main memory. So it will store that address in which register? MAR. So MAR contains the address where the instruction is available in main memory. So because processor want to take that instruction now for execution, so that address will be stored in memory address register. Okay. Now after that, the instruction will be brought from main memory, and temporarily that instruction will be stored in one register known as IR. What is the full form of IR? Instruction register. Instruction register stores the currently executed instruction. Whichever the instruction our processor has taken from memory, that instruction will be stored in IR, instruction register. Let us say first instruction has been fetched now. Okay, now not only that instruction will be stored in instruction register, but also the copy of that instruction will be stored in one more register. We call this register as MDR. MDR stands for memory data register. Memory data register. You can see double sided buses here. The double sided arrows indicates not only the data will be passed from main memory to MDR, from MDR to main memory also. Okay, so MAR stands for memory address register, a memory data register, instruction register. And what is PC? Program counter. What program counter will do? Let us say first instruction has been fetched now and it has been executed successfully. Then the program counter value will become 1. When second instruction has been executed successfully, program counter will become 2. Let us say in our program 10 instructions are there, then the value of program counter will become 10, which means all the 10 instructions have been successfully executed and the final output has came. So program counter will keep track of how many instructions have been successfully executed. That work will be taken care by program counter. And along with these inbuilt registers, there are from general purpose registers also. We call them as ungeneral purpose register. There will be depending on our computer. Okay, computer's hardware architecture or our CPU architecture, there will be n number of general purpose registers. What is the main purpose of using these registers? You know, when we write some programs, let us say I have written one instruction in our C language, C is equal to A plus B, then the value of A will be stored in one register R0, the value of B will be stored in one register R1, and finally the result of C, whatever the result will be assigned to C, it will be stored in some more register R2, like that. So for physically they are variables for us, but internally our CPU will store the values of those variables in registers at the time of execution. Hopefully it has been cleared. To store those values, general purpose registers are used. Okay, and once they are stored in those general purpose registers, now the time for calculation. Now who will do that calculation work? Arithmetic and logic unit will do the calculation work, which means in our case, in this instruction, we need to do which calculation here? Addition calculation, summation we need to do. That addition will be done by our ALU, and this entire work will be handled by our which unit? Control unit of our processor. Control unit will monitor all these activities. Okay, so once again, my dear students, let me once again revise it so that it will be clear to you. First, from where we need to get the data, that will be specified in MAR, memory address register. So that required data will be brought and it is stored in memory data register, and the copy of the data will be stored in instruction register at the time of execution, and the value of PC will become 1 once this particular instruction has been executed, and the values of those instructions will be stored in general purpose registers. And whenever the time will come for calculation, that calculation work will be taken care by arithmetic and logic unit. And who will monitor all these activities? Our control unit will monitor all these activities. See the thing that is going on inside our system. All these things will be behind the scenes. We can't see. Once we get the idea of our computer organization subject, then easily we can able to tell what is happening inside our computer, what is happening in our smartphones. Easily we can tell. So the knowledge of computer organization is must for each and every student. Okay, hopefully you have liked this today's topic. I will continue more concepts related to addition and subtraction algorithms, or multiplication algorithm, division algorithms. Those are also very integral part of our CO. In my next set of videos, surely I am going to upload that also. Okay, the thing that I am not going to complex concepts at a time, because there are many students, if you learn from scratch, it will be easy for you. Finally, you can able to solve any complicated problem. That's why the reason that I have started from basic and slowly I am going to the depth of our CO. And finally, once I will complete the playlist of CO, hopefully you will think that how much easy the subject is, because my channel main purpose is to make something very simple for all of you. Okay, so with this, let me close my today's session of video. See you soon. Take care. Allah Hafiz.